we're back here. Okay,
I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old friend.
Why are you crying, sweetheart?
Crow?
Because you're not real.
I'm not.
What is going on?
Something's being trippy. Oh god, the mannequin head.
I guess I did that?
Yeah, a little.
Kiddo, look on the bright side, would ya?
What bright side?
You made a new friend today.
I don't feel drunk.
Gotta say, that was some fight. She nearly took your head off.
Yeah, I shouldn't have handed her the bat. Okay, we just drove past her, now we drove past her again.
What do you care?
Sorry, sweetheart. I guess I'm getting into your personal business.
What's past is prologue and shit.
Sometimes people need you, though.
And third time? Oh,
even
God.
When they don't admit it.
That face couldn't have been any more terrifying. Hello?
Rachel!
Train? And... alright. You fell asleep inside the car? Guess it's better than the ground, but even still. Your mom is going to be so mad at you. He wasn't taken out by a train though, right? He was taken out by a semi. There's another... well, something signifies the crows in this game. I'm not going to argue against it because I am happy. And I took the crow shirt, so I mean... you didn't go far.
You came. I'm glad. Hey. I couldn't let the day end with whatever this afternoon was.
Chloe, I want to talk to you about something, but
I don't know how to talk about this. You don't have to tell me anything you don't want to. You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman? The ones who were making out? That was my dad.
Oh, no.
All right. And that woman was definitely not my mom. Oh. The worst part is, I'm not surprised. I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was. So when I saw he got a text from an unknown number asking him to meet, I thought I could catch him or something.
And you're dead.
I'm so sorry, Rachel. I don't know what to say. Neither do I. Chloe, I love my dad. I love him. And I never want to see his fucking face again. When my dad died, I was so mad at him. For months, I felt wrong because half the time I thought of him, I wanted to scream. And the other half, I forgot. Forgot that anything had changed. It's silly, but I've carried this photo around with me for years. It's from Mount Hood. My dad took me hiking there when I was 10, and it started raining, and I fell and broke my arm 3 miles from the car. I remember screaming like I was gonna die, but my dad, he carried me down the mountain. I still remember the smell of his coat, and how calm he was, and the sound of his voice, and
okay, well,
he was
sorry.
Just so strong, you know? I felt safe. You trusted him. Completely. Here. Chloe, I owe you an apology. Hey, we were both kind of the queen of shitty. No, I mean it. Meeting you, this friendship, it means more to me than you can possibly imagine. I just want you to know, I'm lucky that you were with me today. You're a badass, Chloe Price. What? Remember that biker asshole who wouldn't let you into the mill? You talked your way right past him. You saw
that? How did you know about that?
And those skeevy douchebags who followed you upstairs? Two against one. But you wouldn't take any shit from them. I'd be dead if you hadn't thrown that bottle. You inspired me. What about Drew? When he was picking on Nathan? You got right in his face and called him out. That was pretty sweet, actually. See? You're the real thing, Chloe. I don't know anyone like you. Plus, you came along with me, no questions asked. Well, I don't really need a good reason to ditch school. I guess tomorrow there'll be hell to pay. My mom might skip grounding and just go straight to the death penalty. And my dad will definitely punish me with... I'm so sorry, Rachel. Fuck him.
Yeah, I guess I could
have
said that.
Leave this place and never look back. What's stopping us? Us? Are you serious? There's nothing keeping me here. Not anymore. So, if I came to you tomorrow and told you to pack your bags... I'm serious. Let's do it, Chloe. Let's leave this place forever. Okay. borrow your lighter?
Don't burn down the place,
Thank
though.
You.
Okay, yeah, see, don't do that. Hope there's something in that trash can. Weird, disappointing Evan.
Come on.
Oh, there it goes. Evan, we signed that petition. Oh my God. Rachel! Oh my God, we seriously restarted a forest fire, bro. That's the end of episode one. Awake, dear heart. Ah, 64% attack, 36% ran. Okay, I ran. Kind of Joyce. Defending Nathan. 71% people told Rachel that you were more than friends. Okay. That's all that mattered? No. Okay. Didn't take the money. Yep. You didn't purchase pot for Frank. Yeah. You read Joyce's self-help book. Almost even. You didn't put the photo of William on the dresser. What photo? Where? I don't know. You didn't slip money into Joyce's purse. Oh, we could have took the money and done that. But she probably wouldn't have been happy about it. You told Elliot you would go to the play with him. Yep. You told Skip you liked his demo. You told Skip his demo was okay. You didn't listen to Skip's demo. People didn't listen to his demo. Finish the table, gang. Mm-hmm. Didn't sabotage your homework. Majority of people told Rachel falling in love is stupid. Shared the earphones. You jumped off the train. No questions asked. Got it.
Shit.
No one steals from me.
I didn't steal anything.
I want my fucking money.
Besides the shirt. Is that what you're after? Brave New World. Chloe's story continues in the next episode. Buy more episodes now. What? What do you mean buy? I hope I don't have to. I shouldn't have to, right? Oh my god, I do. No, that's so messed up. Great. Why would they do that? I'll have to look into that and see how much they are later, I guess. Well, until next time then. Well, alright. Well, bye, I guess.